right, so I could ask the photographers to move away. Excellent. Very good. So, hello and welcome to the headquarters of the European Bank for Reconstruction and Development here in London for today's Western Balkans Investment Summit. My name is Jonathan Charles. I'm the EBRD's Managing Director for Communications and Business Information Services, as well as a member of the bank's executive committee, and I'll be moderating this morning. It's great to see people physically here in the auditorium. You might remember the last time we gathered 2 years ago was actually the last time we had a physical summit here in the room. And so it's fitting that the first physical summit we could have as the pandemic starts to allow that It is a great pleasure to be moderating our event today. See some of you joining us physically here in the auditorium at the EBRD, many more joining us remotely online at this high-speed event. This event is being streamed live on EBRD.com as well as via Zoom. For our audience on Zoom, you can put questions to our Prime Minister's panel in the chat box, so please do that or read something out. That's introduce yourself when you post your question, by the way. We'll take your questions after these short introductory statement. We're glad to be joined by all six Prime Ministers from the region, as well as the EBRD President and the European Commissioner for Neighbourhood and Enlargement. Over the next couple of hours, we aim to throw a spotlight over the investment opportunities in the region and discuss how to overcome some of the economic challenges and investors of the diverse sector in their questions. The Western Balkans is a region we care passionately about at the EBRD. The EBRD is the target for multilateral development and investment. Now, without further ado, let us press on and really get underway. First of all, let's hear from the President of the EBRD, Odile.
Representatives of the business community, ladies and gentlemen, we see the great performance in the performance of the Western Balkans Prime Ministers. That is my first and our focus is on the Western Balkans. As we gather here in Hong Kong today, I just want to say a few words about what is happening in the world of the Ukraine and in what is in our mind. We are in the of the Ukraine. We need the other people to be coming out of the morning. We can get into the day. And we express our strong commitment to the Ukraine development of the neighboring borders in the United States. And the goal of the world already is to go for the one thing. Since the day of the people of the South, and the leaders of that side, the government, and the campaign in the area of Ukraine and express the position of the people of the South, we have to deal with the impact of the pandemic and the political process. And there is much to be done in terms of the region's business environment. But the participation of the public in this event and the very forward movement of the rest of the world about the importance of the fantastic regional cooperation and the airplanes in Europe. Let us call it this very important. What the Prime Minister wants to say. and are very confident, and every confidence that can go to regional cooperation is a side point for the economic prospects and political development for the Western Balkans. The EBRD is an important point of cooperation for the and we are committed to continuing to be so important to Europe. The EU, EIB, and other allies for us that we find EBRD is a very reliable partner in implementing the economy and the political economy. Our landmark is describe what we think is better and most important for our children, especially our children. I'm very happy to report that around the 50 countries which are growing the kids are in the Western Balkans. The banks are the main priorities in all of our regions, and the political importance in the Western Balkans are digital and square what we need. On digital, we aim for EBRD to be the personal choice for our clients in government and the private sector to maintain the conventions of the digital economy. To do that, we reinforce the quality level capacity building and the rollout of broadband infrastructure. And we invest in the digitalization of the private sector to continue to change. Growth is a significant story for us. Our women in this program has disbursed more than 400 sub-loans to women-based SMEs that operate in the middle of the region. And we are now applying the success of our women in this program to the other in the region. This year, we will be launching a youth business program aiming at promoting youth entrepreneurship and enhancing their role in local economies. The region is great potential for investment in developing fields for food. It handles a stable macroeconomic climate, a favorable perspective, a competitive labor force, and the prospect of integration into the European Union. It plays a key stabilizing factor. The region's people are very skilled, young, highly skilled, and among them, many I believe that the Western Balkans are well placed to advance the global network and to take advantage of global trends going forward as the region is more competitive globally and that growth is more sustainable. The Prime Minister, as the Prime Minister of Holland, we have much to discuss in our bilateral meetings later. And I'm greatly looking forward to meeting these across the country and to the rest of the region in the near future. Ladies and gentlemen, for many years now, EBRD has led the way on investment in Western Balkans. We will continue to deal with the climate and conditions whereby we as a whole can commit to the world. The summit is another opportunity for us together to focus on the region's development. And to invite investors of the world to join us in realizing the future of the world.
Thank you very much for your attention. Thank you very much. So now we move on to the next part of our meeting. I welcome the European Commission to the Neighbourhood and the Environment. Very well, the value of the Corporation
that we must create between 26% and 54% of the world. We need forward internet cooperation on all the 14 countries that we have to continue to provide. The implementation of the plan is already underway. You may have seen it this last week. We have launched the first major budget investment. The most important step in terms of turning this plan into reality. Rule, the Western Balkans Investment Framework, in partnership with the EBRD and, of course, other financial partners, member states in Norway, with the investment in 2021-2040. And these projects are already transformed. The environment climate clean energy to the goals of human development. And the investment is roughly 3.2 billion euros spent on the planet. This is just 1.1 billion euros on the planet. That is not the budget. The key first budget message we support, for example, the construction of the Middle East and Europe connection between Scorpio and the Hungarian border. We have the energy sector. For more strategic and mature projects, including the first project, providing alternative gas technologies for Russia. And we are in the process of deploying a new production facility in the Western Balkans to scale up the investment of public cloud, the position of public and private cloud. The CDBRD has an essential. Especially for investments in the energy and digital sector, but also in supporting the competitive infrastructure of the sector and the competitive with the substantial investment that is approved on the right partners of board, which is now time to have several different. Of course, I found all the prime ministers in the question box. Because they need to ensure. And the plan can come to life with it. Together we can and we will change the reality of the world for people that don't have it. At the same time, we continue to work together to challenge the mountain process. Europe does not have a strong level of development, but it becomes naturally the one to do. More important now than ever. Work on both public and private interests. To see the region of Paris in the EU part, better than we have put in place a revised optimized methodology, making the process more credible and from the support more dynamic and giving it a kind of practical scale. We have seen already some positive results. Last year, the progress made with the countries already reported, the process of land planning, the process of public, which could have started for the development of the country. This is of course, an unprecedented situation in the world, in Europe, being supported. Of course, there could be other things that can happen. But I'm convinced as long as we keep doing work together, as long as we work tremendously on the truth and the truth, being challenged around the world, we can contribute to the one thing that is important. And this is why, no matter how you do it, my
Well, welcome to the Prime Minister.
To apologize for not being there physically, but it is quite busy in Serbia, and I've rescheduled some of my travels there as well. And also, you know, I have to emphasize that the elections in Serbia will be almost exactly in 1 month's time. Anyway, I'm the outgoing Prime Minister. But the stability in Serbia will not change. Serbia is doing great. Serbia's economy is doing great. We have some fantastic results despite of the pandemic, and I think really it is the right time to invest in Serbia. We have a very good business environment, which was also confirmed by, for example, the Financial Times, which has proclaimed Serbia as the world champion in FDI attraction two times in the last 5 years. And the results really show, despite the pandemic in 2020, our GDP declined only 0.9%. So our GDP level basically remained in 2020 almost the same as pre-pandemic level, so only the same as in 2019. And in 2021, we have seen a very fast recovery and further growth in our economy. And the GDP growth in 2021 was plus 7.6%. Also in 2021, we have seen the record high FDI attraction with €3.9 billion investment all coming into Serbia only in 2021. I think that Serbia is in terms of investment attraction, one of I think the most interesting countries for investment destinations in Europe or nowadays, and especially if you are an investor which wants to or is considering investing in research and development, the creation of intellectual property, artificial intelligence, bioeconomy. These are the sectors that we are continuing to support very, very heavily. Which contributes to the level of investment in Serbia and the speed of our development. Finally, I would like to say that we are very committed to regional cooperation and building a better, more prosperous region. And regional cooperation and regional stability is, I would say, second biggest priority insofar as foreign affairs. The first topic would be EU integration and our commitment to becoming a member of the European Union. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Prime Minister. We'll come back to another question let me turn now to the new subject of the export of state questions to the Prime Minister. Why can the state put more money into the state of the EU?
Of this domestic subsidiaries, a total conference which contains the topic of technology procurement,
suggestion for special disaster players to
in
most of your business activities can be handled online, including tax administration services. And it's from full-time the contract enforcement and the resolution of commercial disputes. We have recently formed the creation of commercial court. Our economy grew in real terms 12.1% in the first 9 months of 2021. And we expect full-year growth to close at double digits. This was mainly as a result of good management of the pandemic. We had the fastest vaccination rate in Asia. And we used only AstraZeneca and Pfizer, only those who are qualified in the European and American region. This allowed us to reopen the economy faster, increase exports for services for all diaspora, who came in record numbers. For a 60% increase in exports of goods to Croatia, and we also were getting targets in public opinion. So we increased government revenues, and we decreased government expenses. Lending in the financial sector grew by 15.5% last year, and the rate of non-performing loans is the lowest in the region at only 2.7%. Corporate income tax rates were 10%, and total employer contribution for the employee 5% of gross salary. That goes to the pension fund. Our debt to GDP is only 20%. It's the lowest in the region and the second lowest in Europe, and our interest expense is less than 2% of our wages. As such, there won't be any problem in the future income taxes to finance and put it in the private. In conclusion, we still have a very competitive position compared to the region in more than 1 year. And offers a range of opportunities for investment. Lastly, but most most important, we have political stability in place, and we look forward to have more investment for greater growth for win-win situations of freedom. Thank you.
And on the other hand, we are seeing more and more African American sectors, which is a very strategic case as well. And the science group is the green. And we are now on the way because the massive investments in energy with, of course, foreign companies. The same tends to
thank you very much for your comments. We move on to our last Prime Minister, Scotland. Why should investors put their money into the more sensitive investment in the private sector? Use as much paper as you like, but I'm going to ask you. Thank you.
philosophy of culture. What I mean here in the next year for the new year around the first festival, the last of the first festival, here in the next year for the general war, the Sustrani is super bad, really to try to make the first festival, we have to only want to try to have the first festival in the next year for the first festival. One of the reports for last year, one of the reports for Vojnim stavima Bosne i Hercegovine, je politika koja je Bosne i Hercegovine, a ti se razumijem stavili u Bosne i Ukrajine, onda je stavili u Bosne i Hercegovine, na treba investicije, na treba investicije za djecu, a na djecu gdje je imam ogrom potencijal za takozvane obnovljive izvore energije, a još i jedne investicije mislimo da stavili nije za gora, nije za iba, nije za ono što bi stavili za prijatelje investicije. Nama treba investicije koje se izvoje infrastrukturno pogledaju što možete na sredine, bez odbora da li se auto put stara u Beograd, ili je svog komunikacija koja se pogledaju za pogledajte gravi do Beograda. Ono što ovaj put u Bosni Hercegovini potrebno, potrebno su dobre poruke ovdje od vas, da vi predstavite Bosni Hercegovini onako kako ste i vi imali predsjednu trenutku i da kažete koliko je to uspješnih projekata da se to što je uspjela pravda je sudavno da je uspjela pravda je sudavno da je sudavno. Ono što za mene od izuzetne važnosti jeste da se sredino realizacije projekata. To što govorimo o zadovoljnim projektima, ali ne realizacijim projektima, to što je uvijek sa potpobrišnim slabosti, nikak ne, toga mi ne možemo da podignemo kao zemlje, da neke projekte, neke novice koje se može projekti podignemo mi smo u sredstvu. Ono što Bosni Kosovo treba jeste ulaganje u infrastrukturu, autoceste, ceste, železnička pruga, zatim značajno ulaganje energetskih mnogo izvora energije, to su projekti oko kojih možemo pokupiti i niti smo investitore i privatne investitore. Naravno, proces digitalizacije u kojem se čini se ne samo Bosna Kosova, nego cijeli Balkan značaj imate zašto. Je to ako pozni godina je vrlo da se u Bosni Kosovini, Bosni Kosovini se u Bosni Kosovini prema stranim investitorima, Bosni Kosovini u kojoj je dobro u Bosni Kosovini u Bosni Kosovini, Bosni koji su građani potrebili za mir i razvoj.
Prime Minister, thank you very much for indeed. And before we go into our second round of questions, let me ask you a question on the EBRD perspective. How do you see this region developing?
Well, as I was saying, thank you to Obama and thank you all for the enlightening contribution I see here, Mr. Chair, about, first of all, macroeconomic stability. I think that's a very important aspect. What we see in all countries is a strong rebound post-COVID. Countries have been affected in the Western Balkans quite differently by COVID. I mean, the 2020 results were quite different, but everywhere I think we see a strong rebound and a commitment to ensure a stable macroeconomic framework, which is a very strong asset. And the second thing I draw from this first round of discussion is also a very strong commitment to be welcoming to foreign investment to provide assistance to improve the business environment, to facilitate, simplify foreign investment, have a stable tax framework and so forth. I think moving forward, that's very important, is also the next barrier in integration. And I think that's also the value of the discussion today to have all prime ministers defending and presenting the pictures and the specific positive elements of the economies but also the collective approach and the regional dimension, which I think is very important for investors because these countries are all neighbors and developing trade
common approaches and it was very important for investors in terms of size of the market and the cost, and I think that's the very important element in the life. And the third very important element is in terms of perspective, what the connection means in the EU support in terms of financing infrastructure and improving connectivity, developing SME human capital and so forth. And I think this is also an element which, and we see that in the past in Central Europe, it's why the EU perspective is a very strong drive for the reform agenda, and also provides a lot of opportunities for investment that are in investment for the future, gives the opportunity for companies to invest in the project, but also enhance and improve the connectivity and the capacity to invest, trade, and grow in this country.
So the next question is, what are the priorities
I will try to be very brief, and I've outlined three key priority areas as well as three key priority projects. In terms of priority areas, then certainly connectivity agenda, so infrastructural connections between us, railways, highways. The second priority is certainly energy stability, energy projects, and energy diversification. And the third key priority is certainly environmental protection, because a lot of the environmental protection projects really depend on our regional cooperation. In terms of concrete projects, then certainly highway between Belgrade and Sarajevo that we are already building from the Serbian side. The second priority project is the highway, so-called highway of peace between the city of Gymnich, Pristina, then Tirana, and the port of Durres in Albania. And the third project is certainly the gas interconnector from Serbia to Bulgaria to enable us gas diversification and getting the gas from LNG terminals in Greece. Finally, the overall, the most important project overall for us is Open Balkans Initiative that we are implementing with North Macedonia and Albania, and which is certainly open to everyone else to participate. I hope everyone else will join.
Thank you very much, and thank you for this admirably concise. Thank you very much. Let's move to our next Prime Minister, Mr. Kovacevski. What are your priorities?
Thank you for the great philosophy. This is the share of 2021, I voted for the control of the powers of the political system. There was a creation plan that was in the document that I reached in terms of the financing of the resources, together with mechanisms to improve the implementation of the investment. The focus is in early information, in increasing the digitalization of the capabilities of the country's teams, students, and in platforms with the citizens, as well as infrastructure in roads and highways. At this moment, the biggest project was Tenerife, connection with Macedonia with Bulgaria, and Macedonia with Albania, both in terms of highway, express, and railways, plus digital connection. Electricity connection with 400 kilowatts, both Macedonia with Albania, and certainly a new connection with Greece, another one, 400 kilowatts. Very importantly, the interconnected, just interconnected with this. as this will provide energy transformation, but diversification of resources, and will give also possibility for the other countries of the Western Balkans to connect, to this pipeline. This is combined also with the investment which is coming in the local energy terminals. So, very important, as the pandemic taught us that we have to work in front, and we have a new project which is a new clinical center in Skopje, and which is also particularly ready for financing, and the investment in education and in science, which is very much connected with the engineering industry, which are increasing different degrees in the country, especially with the software and the other related services. So, in infrastructure, rolling subjects, gratification of the country, energy transformation into green, and especially transformation of the river plants into gas plants, phosphate, and after that, when they provide enough base energy to further improve the photovoltaics and the wind investments, which already practically started. Some of them in implementation and some of them in implementation.
Let me turn to Strasco to the topic. Let me ask you, what are your country's top priorities?
There is a combined project of the education of the tourism and the system of the German, and as well as the health care of the system of the Nekako je on stalno na mađini za stalno, na mađini za stalno, premijer Makedonije to istakao, predstavu dobrog obrazovanja, kvalitetnog obrazovanja i zdravstva, ne samo što je zato našu mladost na tim prostorima i mislim da to što je Crna Gora uradila po prvi put, da se 6 godina realizirala jedinstvenu listu ključnih sveta, to govori o toj našoj posvećenosti upravo i toj stavu.
Thank you.
do now is
Thank you.
There are many opportunities, obviously there are challenges like in any other country or any other region of the world in terms of moving towards the full implementation of the Green New Deal or green energy transition. The role that is, there is a huge space for the involvement of the private investors in terms of investing in renewable energy sources, I think, you know, for Serbia, but I guess that is the same case for all of us. You know, almost 100% of renewable energy sources, or the energy that is coming from renewable energy sources currently in Serbia, and I guess, as I say, in the region, is actually coming from private investors. So I do not think that our energy companies are investing in renewable energy sources almost at all. some in wind energy and some in small hydro, but almost 95% of the total energy coming from renewable energy is actually produced by private investors. And there is a lot of room to grow. The biggest challenge, I think, is right now is the balancing of the energy, and that is where the biggest opportunity lies as well. So we have to invest in the transmission systems so that we can utilize our individual energy sources to balance as a region, which will make possible for more renewable energy to come into our systems, for more renewable energy to be produced, and also for a lower price for us to be used in our businesses.
One of the key points which the first year was designed by Gymnich,
Kapitala koje odlasti
Hrvatske pozdravljaju da smo se postupci koji smo dobili od strane Europske komisije za obnovu i razvoj. Mislim da prilazimo kraju zakon nova od usluga i inicijativske. I upravo smatram da sam biti jedan dobar temelj za sve buduće aktivnosti koje se na koje bude radio u tom periodu. A taj veliki potencijal za čiste i solarne i vjetre i hidro energije. Naravno, mi imamo nekoliko prostora gdje mogu imati i sve slučajice solarne elektrane koje još uvijek nismo pokušali aktivnosti na pravi način. Tako da Crna Gora predstavlja jedno dobro mjesto za buduća ulaganja. Želim da istaknem da je autopriva Crna Gora svojim potrošačima ponudila vrlo povoljne uslove da oni samostalno upravo na bazi solarne energije dođu do tog vida predlanja između onoga što mogu sami da proizvode i onoga što im preko priroda omogućava, što predstavlja jedan dobar domaćinski odnos prema svakom pojedinačnom domaćinstvu, a također i privatnom sektoru, pogotovo onome koji se veže za mikro i mala preduzeća.
Well, the challenge is that we need both to equip and adapt and but we also want to make use of the opportunity of the economic investment plan for energy investment. On the one hand, we are compiling energy policy 2022-2030 for the Kosovo. And there, our working group is analyzing all necessary elements to have both affordable prices, but at the same time, sustainable supply. We are going to focus very much so in diversification, digitalization, efficiency. But at the same time, we will need a certain intervention in the existing power plants in order to reduce the pollution. Solar and wind both have potential in Kosovo, and we plan to cooperate closely with private sector on an auction-based approach. And I believe that this is doable, especially linking it with our business community, with agriculture as well, with farmers, in order to decentralize generation of electricity, but at the same time to be able to, in the foreseeable future, to phase out coal and this way to reach both decarbonization and decarbonization.
By completely changing our model of our energy in terms of buying, selling, and value introducing the sales, which we want to do more and more. At the same time, we have now, after the successful bid for photovoltaics, the beginning of the downwards after the whole preliminary work made by the Italian government. At the same time, we are going forward
we all this is gonna continue to diversify our energy production, but still hydro remains our most important source. And that's why we are now investing in a very large project, which practically will allow us to have the missing element of our system, the balance. We are working very well with the Americans, together with the energy production. It's a process thanks to cooperation
to
prilično kratki neki novi stabilni izvore u trenutku kad imamo problema sa stabiliranjem zahtjeva od strane ili ćemo morati učiniti u zadnju modernizaciju zahtjeva od strane kako bi ono suštitili tijeku stabilnost, a proizvodimo dovoljno nešto da se uđe nešto elektrosti stabilnosti.
Thank you very much indeed, Prime Minister. Right, for our next question, you have a maximum of 1 minute each to answer to the question, so we'll keep it very tight. So the question has come from the French Employers Federation Middle, and they are asking what kind of tourism do you envisage developing as part of the economic strategy? Anna Bennett, if I could ask you first for your 1 minute answer.
Well, I had a really good meeting with Nada quite recently in Paris, so we discussed a whole lot of a wide variety of topics, including tourism. But the in terms of tourism, you know, Serbia is really developing the mountain tourism. We have quite a few good mountain resorts, but we need and we would welcome additional investors in the ski resorts in the mountains of Serbia.
Very much indeed. Thank you for the
first of all, mountain tourism, lake tourism, which especially in the higher level, we do. One is to the focus, which is the most important one of the international airport. And then we are also the opportunity to the country for investments in the steam resorts, which are 2,000 plus meters. And also, which is important now, with climate changes, to make it more sustainable. For the rest of with additional alternative tourism experiences which we have, and which will also be part of the competitiveness, local competitiveness project, which was done in the past few years, and which managed to identify investors, private ones, which invested in a small alternative for the capacity to buy the first ones to transfer the money to the
good opportunities for winter holidays, for mountain tours. We have two mountain rings. One is some mountains, the other is the Gora Mountains. They are both also very good for further investment. In particular, in some mountains from the village of Odilista to the village of Restovista. Good spiritual. At the same time, to provide great opportunities for cultural tourism because we are very rich in history and culture. And Rama, you touched briefly on tourism in the previous answer as well, but I
think it's right. And tourism, among all the incredible, we are the most incredible because we are blessed with being mountains. in fields to develop. The mountain side, such as society, as the time we are also adding, for example, a school that wants to do with the growth of it, which is the land, while we were in Europe, as we call it. And we are working now in designing the transformation and development plan based on following the field plan, not only as today in a fully productive natural zone, but also partly in a natural park, which will practically mean a lot. And when I say partly, it's not about little, it's about huge, space and immense potential to develop a certain kind of building. So I think we are blessed with all that, and we are seeing more and more about and as the question to the friend, I say that we have a very, very active presence of a core group with some years ago with not nimble, and now it's working, and the core is having every year more and more content to put its brand and the service. So it's been going on also with other brands, so we are in a good direction.
We do have to stand, but it's still actually our foundation country and region team. But it is the first thing to be credible, so well and take it
here. Okay. About the history of the MLA. Charles to invoke the MLA. Dear Mora, I go back to the MLA of Europe. So we I was told you more about the Mali and everything that I was doing about the Kutrimos. The town of Tanguini, the Vila, was in the United States, which was three in the town of Western Testimony. Which was a faithful, really saying a couple of questions to perform. Before, which is even the international Gymnich, clearly saw by the young, by the national memorial, the story of the Tanguini, to the public is free to progress, but to nešto po sebini mjera na vlast u vrti testini da postoji prave atrakcije u tom je potrebno dvije godine. A ako bi meni neko pitao gdje bih ja ulagao u svoj novac u svoj pitanje po drugom vrti testini, šta bi pitao i to su planine, u skijelista i vrti testini i u objektu za skušnje turista. Imamo veliki broj turista koji dolaze u Bosnu i Hercegovinu, ali slušali smo kad ste ti još uvijek su daleko od onoga što je potrebno za ostalne koji žele da dolaze u Bosnu i Hercegovinu. To je sasvim sigurno najbolje mjesto za ulaganje u svijetu sa kapaciteti i turista u svijetu.
Thank you very much indeed, Prime Minister. And we have a question now, probably going to be our last question, I think it's in the audit, from Anna Kupic, who is asking about digital economy and transition to digital economy and how important this is going to be in the next targets for transition. Anna, then, if I can provide details to that.
Sure, and I will try to keep it short because this really is one of our key strengths, and certainly my personal priority, because I do see that digital economy and the fourth industrial revolution is a unique opportunity for countries like Serbia to catch up on all of the lost times, and we have almost put all of our eggs in that one basket. So as of 2017, we have introduced coding and programming as mandatory subjects in the primary schools. We have increased the capacities of our technical faculties. We have introduced specialized IT classes in the high schools. Last year, 2021, we had first generation of primary school kids leading school with a full knowledge of key coding languages such as Scratch and Python, Pygame. And we see a fantastic return on investment on everything that we have done. Our IT sector is currently the biggest exporting sector from Serbia, bigger than agriculture. Its participation in our GDP is bigger than, for example, tourism or construction. Our exports from IT was about 1.8 billion euros only in 2021, and the surplus is 1.3 billion euros. We have doubled the number of people employed in the IT sector. So we do see the digital revolution as a key driver of our economy. And as I said, the next big thing for us, thing that we will invest in, is the AI, development of AI and bioeconomy, biotech, biomed, bioinformatics, biodiversity. So for anyone who's interested in investing in IT, Serbia really is the best place. And finally, I'm glad with this, just about 2 weeks ago, the World Economic Forum has decided to establish its center for fourth industrial revolution in Serbia. So I was in Geneva, and as of 1st of March, the World Economic Forum will have its center for fourth industrial revolution here in Belgrade.
Thank you very much indeed. Ross, we are, have to be very brief, we are running up against time. Our Prime Minister Kovacevic, please.
But one of the most students have enrolling into the IT-related studies in the country. Number two, more and more investments are coming in the IT field, so IT industry is really growing in terms of number of employees, in terms of turnover, export, and in terms of above average for 2.5 times salaries, which come in this industry. What follows is really strong support from the government for the IT industry. We are already discussing and developing the new government program. Increase of taxes for the up to a level of zero in order to really support and to make more consideration of the hub for the IT industry, and together with the fund for innovation. The major fund we are also discussing the possibility for the implementation of a digital nomad concept in the country that we can attract to foreign IT programmers to work and
Obudi to mlade da se bavio tom problematikom. Imam slučno stubova, mlade sve na teren, ovo što sam da se vidio, upravo je bilo vidjeta na tom problematiku. To sam imam pokušali da obrazimo i kroz javnu opremu, time smo izgubili mnoge registrovane najveće moguće nivo, očekujući te ljudi od ljudi razvijena, ali isto tako kroz novo formirani, kojom za inovaciju sam imao da se učemo, što je veći broj mladih ljudi koji bi se bavili tim vrlo unosnim poslom i koji bi dali dodatno jedno prijedno na istom ugore. Također, pravili smo posljedne za digitalne nomade koji bi na možda izbjedili dovoljne preduslove da mogu samo gore da nasu što su mjesečno angažovanje u njih odgovoru.
Thank you very much indeed. Same question to other people.
Well, in Kosovo, people are already digital because we have 96% of penetration, concentration in households. But at the same time, now we want to have government and administration going to the state. So I took office 11 months ago. One of my principal advisors has been an appointee as the chief technology officer, who is the driving force of the digital government in Kosovo, with a threefold goal. to influence accountability, transparency, and quality of services. We see challenges ahead because we want digitalization not only in state administration but also in healthcare sector, in industry, and in education. Regarding what we have been doing in this level, I would like to emphasize the fact that all the measures from the economic revival package that we have introduced during the fight against pandemic COVID-19, the applications and the implementation of new technology. So, this is a great example of how we can
succeed. Very much, and thank you for that. I think I was actually telling you that this is previously for the information that the strategy of the device of the system of service solutions and at the same time, this will be putting the education about new technology. But I just want to add that we are now in a way to do space and parliament already legislation about startups and digital nomads, which is actually the most incredible and liberal in terms of no regulation about startups and digital nomads, not only in the region, but in the whole world, and maybe in all the comments.
Thank you very much. I'm making incredible my word of the day, by the way. Prime Minister, tell me.
Just a quick word of like to say thank you. I'd like to first of all ask for the many arrival messages and news of the most of the city areas. Malik for our real estate strategy, you are the good for the guys to be for all the strategy, Over the last 6 years, pandemic and also the thousand last first labs to the results of the same as the connection of the Zolania, the support of the national institution that was on the table. The program is that the beginning of the digitalization, the other main level project of the strategic and minister for the US to support our efforts to the last of the past. Now, the service mali ljudi koji rade u Bosni i Hercegovini ostvaruju značajne rezultate finansijski u polju projekta i ali se tu onoga što oni treniraju se izvodi u poslu poslu koji rade među institucije Bosni i Hercegovini u Bosni i Hercegovini u Bosni. To je jedan veliki posto za koji mi stanski uspuni pristup.
Thank you very much indeed, Prime Minister. And thank you very much to all of our six prime ministers for joining us today, the European Commission, of course, and also the EBRD president, which has ever been a very stimulating topic of ours. Thank you to the online audience as well for your questions. If you want to know more about what the EBRD is doing in the Western Balkans, please take a look at our website, ebrd.com, where you'll find all the information. If you're watching on Zoom or ebrd.com, thank you for joining us, and goodbye. If you are here in this room, we are about to take a family photo of the Prime Minister, and then you'll be back here for the coffee break outside. Thank you very much for this.